In this video, we shall see building mortars, types of mortars, requirements, grouting and gunniting, a little introduction. Let me show you the formal definition for a mortar. It is a paste which is capable of setting and hardening prepared by adding water to a mixture of binding material and fine aggregate. Here that binding material may be cement, may be clay, may be gypsum or may be lime. Or combination of these materials like clay gypsum, gypsum lime and lime cement. I will show you a monument, famous monument which is constructed as an ingredient. One of the mortar used was lime mortar, and for Egypt pyramids the combination of clay gypsum, gypsum lime and lime cement mortars were used. So let us see the classification of mortars. What are the types of mortars? So first classification is based on bulk density. So we can classify them as heavyweight mortars, lightweight mortars, and another one is based on binding materials like cement, lime, gypsum, mud or composite mortars. Third one is based on applications where we are using, like bricklaying mortars, finishing mortars or special mortars. And the another last classification is based on physical and mechanical properties, based on the strength, let me say. Here this was divided as 9 grades. Starting from 0.4 to 30 Newton per mm square, accordingly it was divided into 9 grades, and we shall call the mortar with that grade name. So let us see the characteristics of good mortar now. So it should possess good strength, and it has to resist the penetration of rain. There should not be any percolation of rain. Mobility and placeability. We have to carry it and we have to work with it easily. That is workability. Water retention. So it has to retain water on it. It should avoid any percolation in that. It has to retain and carry water in that. Let me tell you the popular types of mortar which are generally being used apart from the classification of mortars. The first one is a cement mortar. So you can see how it looks. The paste, cement paste, and it is mainly the ingredients of are cement, sand and water. Second one is a lime mortar. You can see the color of it, the paste color. The lime is mainly used here, and lime, sand, water are the main ingredients. Surkhi mortar. Surkhi is a brick powder, waste brick powder. So we are using it instead of sand, or sometimes it may be used along with the sand. Mainly used in lime mortar. Lime, surkhi, sand, water are the ingredients. So another one is a mud mortar. Here we can see how it looks. It is prepared by locally available materials. Of course, we will be seeing all of them one by one later. Clay and cow dung are the important ingredients. Cow dung is a fibrous and it helps to arrest the cracks. Another one is the lime cement mortar. So this is so here we are using lime as well as cement. So you can see how it looks. This is a lime mortar, this is a cement mortar, and this is how lime cement mortar looks. And these are the ingredients: lime, cement, sand, of course, water. And special mortars, these are based on the functionality where we are using. According to functionality, we will be using. Let us see all of them one by one. Let us see the first one, cement mortar. If you see the cement mortar, cement is the binding material and it imparts adhesive power and strength. Adhesive power is nothing but it has the power of bonding to different materials. Cohesive means same materials, bond between same materials. Sand is adulterant but increases crushing strength and reduces the shrinkage. Sand will be good when it is used in the limit. It is also adulterant, so many people will use more sand in order to increase the volume. So that is not good. It has to be in proportion what is mentioned. So I will show you the proportions also. Water acts as a lubricant. It spreads the binding material uniformly and fills the pores. So water is a important ingredient to keep all the materials together. Now see how the proportion should be. So if you are using in brick masonry and all, the cement mortar should be 1:4.4 to 5. That means one part of the cement is, if one part of cement is used, you can carry 4 to 5 parts of the sand. So for plastering, interior, exterior. So 4 to, and sand parts are 4 to 5.6. Pointing, for all one parts of the cement, for pointing, the sand can be used as 1 to 3 parts. Point is nothing but the bricks which can be the brick mortar. The joints are being the joints can be pointed, so that will be looking beautiful when it is pointed, not plastered or masonry jointed. Reinforced brickwork. So this is one part of the cement. We can use three parts of the sand foundation for foundation. This is 3.4. There's only 3.4 or 3 to 4. This average was given. Second type, there's a lime mortar. You can see how it looks, and lime here acts as the binding material. So we have two types of limes, fat lime and hydraulic lime. So fat lime contains high calcium oxide content, and its hardening depends on the water absorption water and absorption of carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. Hydraulic lime contains silica, alumina, iron oxide in some quantities, forms putty when mixed with it and set hardened under water. You can see the putty also in your homes when it is being constructed. The small gaps are being filled with that. But of course, it will be used as a mortar too. Sand in lime mortar supplies carbon dioxide and allows the air for setting of lime mortar. Sand is also an important ingredient. The functionality is different when it comes to lime mortar and cement mortar. So this is how the proportions should be. Fat lime, when you are using fat lime, 1 to 2 parts of the lime will be used. 2 to 3 parts of the sand should be used. And fineness modulus of the sand should be 2 to 3. And it has to pass from 4.75 millimeter sieve. So that is the fineness modulus. You have to check. Types of the work may be plastering. So for the pointing, these are the specifications. And hydraulic lime, when you are using, these are all the considerable proportions, and it is used for masonry hydraulic lime mainly. So let us see the third one, Surkhi mortar. So where the brick powder is being used, is a brick powder, it should pass through 4.75 mm micron sieve, and it furnishes the hydraulic properties to the lime mortar, and it is prepared in the same way as the lime mortar, but only thing is you are adding Surkhi additionally. And here you can see how the proportions are mentioned. So for masonry and foundation, Surkhi should be used for one part of the lime. Two parts of Surkhi can be used. When you are using lime Surkhi mortar, one part of the lime and one part of the Surkhi should be used. So lime is common in Surkhi mortar. And sand can also be used. So when the sand is also being used, we have to call it as lime Surkhi mortar. So next type is the mud mortar. So we can see the top 150 to 200 mm layer of earth is completely removed. The ground is wetted and allowed to mature a day or two. So it is kept in wet condition for two days. And later what happens is they will mix it thoroughly. Then this fine paste is formed. It can be used for masonry work, surfacing floors, plastering wall surfaces at low cost houses. So it has to be sprayed with bituminous material in order to improve the resistance to rainwater. Otherwise, it is mud. It can be simply eroded with when rainwater touches it. So, in order to prevent that, we have to spray with the bituminous material so that it can be water resistant. And sometimes the clay can also be added for better workability. Cement clay proportion should not exceed 1:1. Sorry, this is sometimes cement can be added with cement. And cement clay proportion should not exceed 1:1. And cow dung is added because this is a fibrous and it improves the functionality and it improves its work and it will prevent the cracks due to shrinkage. Another type is lime cement mortar. So you can see this is also known as guarded mortar or gauged mortar. So it is very good for water retention, workability, bonding properties and frost resistance. Lime cement are the first mixed separately in the form of the paste. Then cement is mixed in batches. So first cement and lime are mixed. Then we can see how the proportions will be 1:1:6. That is one part of the cement, one part of the lime and six parts of the sand. And that is for outside wall, and these are all the acceptable proportions. 1:2:9, 1:2:9, and 1:3:12. These last two mentioned are for inside walls and above two are for outside walls. Another last type of popular type of mortars is special mortars. So we have to use them according to the function. So for example, filling joints between the precast reinforced concrete components. This is precast. Precast. That is nothing but precast is nothing but we are not preparing the component at the site, but we are preparing it in the manufacturing unit and taking it to the site. That means just like our Hyderabad Metro Rail. So all the components were made, all the segments were made at the site, at the manufacturing unit, and they were transported to the site. So when they were made, what happens is PSC, pre-stressed concrete. So what happens is inside they will extension bars they will insert and they will be pressurized. So they will pull them up and later they will lock them. So initially they will be given stress so that if you apply any load on it, it will be completely coming back, giving its original position. Of course, that is completely different concept. However, the wires which were elongated and locked, and later that wire cabinet will be completely filled by the cement mortar. That is the special mortar. So what we are using here is Portland cement plus quartz sand. Filling grooves inside the PSC, that is pre-stressed concrete, sulfate, alcohol, vinous, and naphthalene soap is added for reducing viscosity. So we have viscosity should be very less in order to inject the cement mortar inside it. Another one is packaging. Sorry for that, it is not appearing clearly. Packaging, cement plus sand or cement plus loam, cement plus sand plus loam. Loam is simply the soil, which is having silt content, sand content, and clay content. So now it is added calcium chloride. It is additive that should be used in order to make it ready for packaging, like tunneling, lining. So tunneling, entire tunneling should be plastered. Packaging, oil wells, etc. So it is completely water resistant, we can say. Another one is damp proofing. Another requirement is for damp proofing. High grades of sulfate resisting Portland cement or pozzolana cement, quartz sand or quartz from crushed rock. These will be used for waterproofing seams and joints. So you can see many water cement pipes. All the cement pipes will be joined when they are being used as a sewers. I mean underground water supplying pipes. So they have to be joined together. So in such cases, we can use these damp proofing mortar. So only the materials will change the functionality. Also some more sound absorbing mortars. So we will use special, apart from all the cement, sand, lime, gypsum, etc. We are using caustic magnesite, pumice, cinders, ceramicite, sands. So these are all the special sands which absorb the sound. These are all sound absorbents. So ceramicite, so you now see that this sand is specially available in China. This is fire shielding mortars. Another one is, so it's a good topic actually, ceramicites. Okay, let us come to fire shielding mortars. So these are, as the name indicates, these will resist the fire. And aluminum cements, finely powdered bricks are excellent combination for making these fire shielding mortars. And this is generally used for furnace linings, chimneys, etc. And the technical name for this is, or generally it is called as Acoset 50. And the last special mortar is X-ray shielding mortars. So these are to shield X-ray rooms, and the Portland cement, slag cements, etc. All are apart from the general materials. Hydrogen, lithium, cadmium components are separately added to enhance the protective properties. So these are all the types of special mortars. So let us now see how to select the mortar. So here I have mentioned very clearly a construction work, nature of the work, type of the mortar, and in which proportions it has to be used. So please check that accordingly. So here we can see as the second proportion, as the second term increases, the strength will reduce. So accordingly, general RCC works, mortars for fire bricks, plaster works, pointing, reinforcing, etc. For all these, we just mention the proportions. So you just check them up after from this document. And testing of mortars. So we have two main tests apart from setting time of the cement and all. We shall discuss them later. However, for mortar, we have two important tests. One is the crushing, one is the permeability. So here for the cement, which is mixed in proportion 1:3, should have the permissible strength up to 0.75. Similarly, you know, for this mixed proportions, this is the strength 1:3, 0.45. Lime mortar, cement lime mortar, for this proportion, this has to be the. Next, specimen diameter. This is for permeability. So permeability is nothing but we have the apparatus where we just place the cement mortar block and we allow water to pass through it and we collect the water here, and how much time the water is percolated into the mortar and filled this container, that is depending on this permeability. So here we can see specimen diameter. If it is 100 mm, 10 cm, here 115 mm per hour, in 1 hour it can allow 115 mm per hour. So this is the dimension of cell in millimeters. So that is all about permeability. So another important topic is grouting. Now you can see how it is being used. So that is a very simple, very modified, very sophisticated equipment. So that is simply, it is made it simple how it is being filled up. Also, it can be used to strengthen the soil like this. So you can see how the GIF is working. So initially it will be drilled and later slowly the grout will be passed through it. That's the grouting. So you are just injecting. You are filling the voids and joints to repair the cracks. To increase the bearing capacity of the soil by injection, this is what I have shown you here. Water cement ratio should be kept as low as possible to increase the strength and reduce the shrinkage. So water cement ratio should be as low as possible because it should be very diluted so that it can be easily inserted into the small cracks. So this is how the compressive strengths and other properties were mentioned. You know, for the good to make it mortar good mortar for grouting. So these are all the mentioned properties. You can just check them up. Gunniting. So gunniting is nothing but you are spraying with the help of a gun like this. So you can see how the cement mortar is being sprayed. So that is generally applied under high pressure through a cement gun. So it's a gun. It is being sprayed. And concrete bonds become extremely strong with help of this, and generally used for lining tunnels. So linings will be sprayed and a layer will be formed like this. Swimming pools lining, repairing of deteriorated concrete damaged by fire, earthquake chemicals, strengthening of rocks, earth slopes, etc. Even if you see some hills. In hill stations also you can see how they are completely covered with the cement paste in order to avoid the sliding of the rocks, or in order to, when the rocks were broken, it has a tendency to slide up. So such cracks will be arrested with the help of this mesh, steel mesh covered by this cement paste spray. And this is how the proportions are mentioned. Nominal mix place in the gun, cement is to sand, mix in place, cement is to sand. This is how the proportion, different proportions will be used. So that is all about the today's topics. So we have seen the types of mortars, requirements, characteristics of good mortars, selection of good mortars. We have seen the technical requirements, that is nothing but testing. We have seen the two tests, importance of those two tests. We are just focusing on the values, and here the grouting and gunniting. Thank you.